What's up? Welcome back to the Divine Melanin Vlog. You know how we do. We love, we lift, we experience life divinely. It's your girl D-Ray, the Divine Relationship Alchemist, helping you to heal your relationship with self in order to heal your relationship with others. Today I have a treasure, a gem, a diamond for you titled, Four Reasons Why All Couples Should Meditate, right? Four reasons why all couples should meditate. And this is vital if you are going to be a spiritual being having this human experience and in a union, in a relationship that is thriving, successful, that is manifesting, and all of those great things that we want to experience in this lifetime, right? So, four reasons why a couple should always meditate. The first one is manifestation, right? In order to manifest, you have to tap in to your subconscious mind, period, right? You have to tap into the subconscious mind. Why is manifesting so important in relationships? Couples that are not creating, couples that are not manifesting things, whether tangible or intangible, are typically not happy, okay? You're not happy in your relationship if you and your partner are not coming together and agreeing upon something and then seeing it manifest, whether that be a house, car, you know, business, a child, whatever. Manifesting is vital in order to have a happy relationship, okay? You have to be seeing continuous progress within your relationship. So, in order to manifest those things that are true, right? In order to manifest those things that come from our heart space, okay? We have to meditate. You have to meditate on those things to truly know that what you want to create is actually going to be beneficial to your life in a higher sense, okay? Rather than just doing things that come from our low vibrational, lower three chakra type things, right? And so when we meditate, either together or separately, meditating nonetheless, both partners, when we meditate, we allow our God, Goddess force to work together, okay, to come together and create whatever it is that we want to manifest more quickly, right? There's this Bible verse where two or three people are gathered together, you know, so shall it be done. However the verse go, you know what I'm saying. When you and your partner come together and you agree that you want to create something and you put your minds to it by way of meditation, voila, happens much faster, right? You have to meditate in order to really be able to manifest for the simple reason that if your thought processes, your thought patterns, your beliefs do not line up with that thing that you want to manifest, it's not going to happen, right? We have to investigate our minds and understand what we are thinking and how that thing may go against, you know, what we want to manifest. So if you meditate and you realize that thoughts come into your head about working instead of being a business owner, you can't manifest that entrepreneurship, all right? So meditation is so important in terms of manifesting as an individual and in a relationship because you have to analyze what thought processes you have going on that will inhibit you from creating what you want to have. Like if you don't believe that you are worthy of manifesting this great thing, then you cannot have it, okay? Sorry, y'all saw me looking off. I was making sure it was recorded. Yeah, you cannot have it if you don't know and believe in your heart that it is for you to have. So meditating allows you to manifest more quicker, okay, as an individual and as a couple. Why? Because you get to break down your mind. You get to understand what thought processes that you have and which ones you need to cultivate and which ones you need to let go of in order for you to manifest and bring things in this reality, right? Okay. When you and your partner come together and decide that you want to create something, it manifests as much quickly. Okay. Much quicker. All right. So the next thing that reason as to why you want to meditate together or separately, but within your relationship period, both partners having a meditation or a spiritual practice, two, is for spiritual enlightenment, right? You do not gain spiritual wisdom, spiritual insight if you're not meditating, right? And relationships between gods and goddesses only thrive if both partners are seeking to know and understand themselves more, right? And so we do that by quieting our minds so that we can hear from our higher self, so that we can hear from more evolved spiritual entities, so that we can grow in light. It says, out of darkness comes light. Meditating is you going into the darkness, right? And the wisdom, the insight, the knowledge, the understanding that you come out of your meditation with is the light, right? And so if you have a person in your, if one of the partners in a relationship is growing in their spiritual knowledge and in their spiritual wisdom, and another person is staying stagnant, then they're kind of growing apart from each other, all right? So in order to have relationships that last and that are beneficial, both partners have to partake in some sort of spiritual practice. You have to be doing some work, okay? Because you both want to be growing steadily together instead of one person growing and then one person kind of staying the same. Then this one person who is growing and obtaining light is kind of carrying the weight of the relationship and the other person is kind of pulling it down. So it's so important to meditate so that we can gain some spiritual enlightenment, so that both persons are evolving and growing individually and then as a unit and gaining light. You have to be growing as gods and goddesses in order for your relationships to grow. And the only way we can do that is by way of meditation. Meditating allows us to witness and observe all the experiences that we are having, right? Jay-Z said it. I told my wife the spiritual shit really works. Alhamdulillah. I run through them all. Da 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 da. Whatever else he says. But the spirituality is what works. The spirituality is what's going to take you to higher realms and then higher realms of thinking, higher realms of being, right? So you have to do the meditating. You have to have a spiritual practice in order to grow in spiritual enlightenment. The next one, right? Peace of mind. Meditating allows you to have peace of mind. It allows you to surrender to the ego. Point blank period, human shit is gonna happen, right? Bills are gonna be due. There's gonna be disagreements. There's gonna be misunderstandings. You're gonna have some human regular drama that we all experience, right? But if you are not meditating, then oftentimes you become consumed in that human drama, okay? It just kind of takes you over. And when that happens, your relationship becomes kind of rocky. You're rocking the boat a little bit, right? When we meditate, it allows both partners to observe the situation from a higher level, more objectively, and not become consumed in it. It says, be in the world, but not of the world. If you are letting drama overtake you and in turn overtake your relationship, then that means you are in this world and you are of this world, right? See, me and other gods and goddesses, we are not of this world. We are from a whole nother place, space, and time, right? And so we understand that we're having this human experience and human things are going to happen. Meditating allows you to maintain peace when that pendulum is swinging, right? Couples who can maintain peace in their relationships are the ones that last, the ones that have this undying love and union. And the way to do this is by having both partners meditating and partaking in some sort of spiritual practice, whether that be yoga, tai chi, there's so many other things, visualizations, just doing something to always remain the observer, okay? To be able to surrender the ego. You're gonna get into disagreements with your mate, all right? But if you can observe and say, okay, look, I'm tripping. Let me take a step back. Let me observe what's actually going on, right? Meditating allows you to do that. Meditating allows you to witness that chatterbox ego that just goes on and on and on and on and on, right? And that's important. It's important to meditate for peace of mind. Peace of mind within yourself, which in turn means peace within your relationship if both partners are partaking. The next one and the last one is creativity. Meditation allows you to have creative energy. It allows you to be that creative force, right? That is so important because if you're in a relationship and one person is not being creative and fulfilling their purpose, they usually become frustrated. You know, you've seen it all before. Somebody that's not working in their purpose, living in their purpose, they become frustrated with life, and in turn, they become frustrated within their relationship. They're unhappy, right? Meditating allows you to tap into that creative energy that is you. Your subconscious mind knows everything, right? It knows everything. There is nothing new under the sun, and your subconscious mind houses all things, right? Meditating allows you to tap into that all. Meditating allows you to tap into your subconscious mind, which houses so much creativity, so much light, so much love, so much any and everything that you could want to create, right? Meditating allows you to understand your unique gift and how you are to uniquely deliver it to the world, right? And so you need that. You need that creativity. You need that spark, that fire, that thing that makes you want to get up and do something today, right? If you have no passion, no purpose, no fire, no fuel under your ass to get you up and doing something, you become frustrated, stagnated, mad at yourself, which in turn makes you mad at your partner. You mad at them because you're not doing what you want to do. You mad at them because you're not tapping into yourself and understanding who you are and what you have to bring here to this realm. All right. So meditating allows you to tap into that creativity. It's so important to be creative in your relationship. You know, you gotta create. And not all times, we ain't talking about just creating babies. That's great. That's dandy. That's lovely. It's beautiful. Like, I know from experience. But we wanna be able to create other things. We wanna be able to put our hands and put our hearts and put our minds to something so special and near and dear to our hearts. And when you are working in your power and in your passion, the love is just through the roof, right? Meditation allows you to do just that. So again, four reasons you want to be meditating within your relationship, either separately or together. Sit down together, say, look, we're going to meditate. And let me go ahead and make this point. If you're meditating and you get an ill vibe or you feel a low vibration frequency from your partner, then that's not the person that you're supposed to be with, right? Period. I've never had an experience like that with my love, dream-wise. When we meditate and we do work together, we getting shit done, period. Instant manifestation. Like, instantly, things start shifting. We already know we cosmic, okay? And so I want my viewers, okay, I want you guys to experience that same thing, the power of meditation. There's endless research on why you should be meditating, right? There's endless research on why you should be meditating. Go listen to Lauryn Hill's song, Selah, right? And then he came, Selah, oh, and it means praise and meditation, and then he came. In that song, she's discussing how meditation is freeing and liberating, right? And that's facts. That's big facts. You have to meditate. Separately or together, nonetheless, meditate, right? Sit your ass down. Play some soft music or some binaural beats, whatever guided meditation, whatever, you know, resonates with you in whatever space and time you are in. But meditation is vital. It's important to meditate for manifesting. It's important to meditate for spiritual enlightenment. You have to meditate if you want to have peace of mind. People are not being quiet. They're not sitting down and quieting their minds. They're just listening to all of this chatter, you know, that is from the external world, that their internal world actually believes is real, right? Okay, and so you don't have peace, right? You have to meditate in order to receive that creative energy. Understand that creativity is a channel, right? A channel from your higher self, a channel for more evolved spiritual entities that want to give you some good knowledge, wisdom, insight, and understanding, right? But if you can only hear the chatter that is in your own head, right, then it is impossible for you to clearly hear yourself, your intuition, right, your higher self. So you want to meditate as a union for those very specific reasons, right? Meditating in your relationship is going to keep that relationship thriving. It's going to keep it strong, beautiful, and full of love and light, all right? Again, welcome to the Divine Melanin. You know how we do. We love, we lift, we experience life divinely. It's your girl, D-Ray, the Divine Relationship Alchemist, helping you to heal your relationship with self to heal your relationship with others. Peace.